In this illustration, we'll analyze the impulse on a hanging rod by Hinge. Here we are given that a uniform rod AB of mass M and length L is hinged at point A, and it is hanging freely to rotate in a vertical plane. We are given that a ball of mass M moving horizontally hits it at a distance d from the hinge as shown. We are required to find d, for which during collision hinge will not exert any impulse on the rod. And in the situation here, we can analyze that if after collision ball moves at a speed v and rod rotates at angular speed omega, then in this situation we can write by conservation of angular momentum. Here we have the initial angular momentum about the hinge. We can write this is m u d, and after collision the angular momentum, if the rod is rotating at angular speed omega and ball is moving with the speed v, we can redraw the figure to analyze. If the ball is coming at a speed u and after collision here, ball moves at a speed v and rod moves at angular speed omega, then in this situation we can write the angular momentum of ball about the hinge at point A is mvd plus that of rod will be in this situation ml square by 3 multiplied by omega, the angular momentum of rod about point A. So this is our equation 1. And we are given that at a particular value of d where the ball is hitting, the hinge will not exert any impulse on rod. That means there is no external force on rod in horizontal direction. So linear momentum of the system should also remain conserved. So we can write as hinge is not exerting any force on rod, linear momentum of system will also remain conserved. This implies, here we can write the linear momentum of ball was mu, and after collision the linear momentum of ball is mv plus that of rod we can write as m, and if it is moving at angular speed omega, its center of mass can be considered to be moving at the speed L by 2 omega. So its linear momentum will be m multiplied by velocity of center of mass, which is L by 2 omega. This will be our equation 2. Now here we can write from 1 and 2, here we can rearrange the terms as mu minus mv d we write as ml square by 3 omega. So here we can write mu minus mv is equals to ml square by 3d multiplied by omega, which should be m into L by 2 omega. Here m omega gets cancelled out, when L also gets cancelled out, and it will result the value of d is equals to 2L by 3. That is the result of this problem. And this is the value of d for which the angular momentum and linear momentum both will remain conserved. And linear momentum conservation implies hinge is not exerting any force on the rod in horizontal direction. As in actual cases, if ball will hit anywhere else, hinge will exert a horizontal force on rod, due to which its linear momentum will not remain conserved. So here our result will be 2L by 3.